Different people in your organization will have different responsibilities with regards to RtReports. One user may be responsible for creating and editing report templates. In this case, this will be Ruby. And a different user may be required to then review that report template before it's released and can be run against batches. For example, that user will be Aaron. Once a report template is released, it can then be used to print reports on event frames in the generator. One person may be responsible for commenting and verifying on that report. And these actually can be separated into two different groups. But for our example, Shrey will be doing that. Once the report has been commented and verified, another user, Rohin, will then need to come in and approve it. And once the report is approved, Liam will come in and officially print that report. To set up these permissions, there are two main places where we make these changes. These are the group privileges and the report security. They're both set up in the RtReports editor. Group privileges are the permissions you will be granted if and only if you are also provided the matching report security settings on a specific report. For example, Aaron is allowed to review reports, but only for those specific reports where report edit is set to allow. And Ruby is allowed to edit reports, but only on the reports where she has been granted report edit allow. In contrast, Shrey, Rohin, and Liam have allow set on some reports under report execute. Report execute means these users have been granted their respective permissions in the RtReports generator for comments, verifications, approvals, printing, or official printing. In addition to these permissions, the review cycles and approval cycles are set up in the RtReports editor. The review cycle defines who needs to approve the report before it is released and can be used to print reports in the RtReports generator. The approval cycle defines who needs to approve a report for a specific batch or event frame before it can be officially printed. Let's start by taking a look at where the group privileges are defined in the RtReports editor. Going to go into the RtReports editor. And log in as an admin user. The easiest way to provide someone with admin access to RtReports is by utilizing the local group RtReports admins on the RtReports machine. By default, this group will always be an administrator. Administrators will then be able to go to the admin tab under group privileges. And I can go ahead and show you, here's the RtReports admin group, which has been allowed all permissions. My five users are in groups A through E. This was Ruby, who's going to be responsible for editing this report. Group B was responsible for reviewing the report so it can be released and then used to print event frame batch reports. Group C was going to be responsible for both commenting and verifying, but you could divide that up into separate groups. Group D is responsible for approving the report once it's been commented and verified. And once it's approved, a user in Group B will be responsible for officially printing. You can also provide access to yet another group if you would like a group to print, but not be able to officially print. That's so that they can make a PDF, but it wouldn't be watermarked as official. Let's go ahead and open the editor as Ruby so we can start the review cycle for this report. Go ahead and open RtReports editor. And I'm going to type in Ruby. And this is a local user just for this example. And let me try and open one of the other reports, the time-based report with equipment. Ruby has not been granted permissions on this report to edit it. And we'll instead get this error. You do not have permissions to see this report. To open a report, Ruby needs to have both the global setting of edit that we already looked at, as well as a specific permission on the individual reports that she's allowed to make edits to. I'm going to open our Potion 1A compliance report that we've been working on and show you where those security settings are that allow Ruby to make edits to this. If I go into the format template, at the root element, I'm going to go to properties. Now, as a review, the second set of settings that we need to set are the report specific ones. Whereas the first two users are allowed to do these items in the editor, and the last three users are allowed to do these specific items on this report in the generator. We also need to show you where the review cycle and approval cycles are determined. If I go to the Advanced tab, I can see here the report edit box. By default, admins will have allow, but here we have groups A and B also allowed. For report execute, admins are allowed along with groups C, D, and E. The review cycle has been defined by someone in group B requiring to do this before the report template is released. And finally, the approval cycles includes one approval by someone in group D before the report can be officially printed. Let's go through all five steps of this cycle. We're already logged into the editor as Ruby, and we finished creating our report. Let's start the review cycle. I'm going to go to Tools, Report Version Manager, and say Mark for Review. This report has now been marked for review, and it's in state in review step 1. And I don't have any of the options to work on this report anymore. The user who's going to be reviewing this report is Aaron. Let's go ahead and log into the editor as Aaron and review this report. I'm going to open up the editor. And I will log in as Aaron, who is also a local user. As Aaron, I'd like to open the report to look at it. As a reviewer, he must be able to see the report. And we could go ahead and do some testing by testing the report and running it against an event frame. But let's say he's reviewed it and he likes the way it looks. I then go to Tools, Report Version Manager, and say Review. And say, I have reviewed this report. And you can click Accept. I have to type in my password for logging purposes. This report has now been reviewed and is available for printing against event frames in the generator. Let's go ahead and log into the generator as our first user who needs to make comments and verifications on this report. As a reminder, that user is Shrey. I'll go into the generator and I'll log in as Shrey, who's again a local user. I'd like to print this report against one of my batches. Let's go ahead and find it. I choose my data server and asset database. And I want to widen my search to about 24 hours. I'll hit search. These are all of my batches in that time frame. I want to run this report template against batch 7225. If I click on it here, and then go to the Reports tab, any of the reports that are valid for that batch will show up as listed here. And it looks like just Potion 1A compliance is valid. Let me click on Potion 1A compliance. And the report will be generated in the browser. As Shrey, I want to make comments and verifications on this report. Here I go ahead and look through my report, and everything looks good. I want to comment on this section here. And for tracking purposes, I need to type in my password. I also want to verify this section. And again, need to type in my password. Let me also comment on the second section. But I'm going to leave out the verification to show you what happens. I'm all done, so I can log out. But let me show you that there is no option to print, approve, or sometimes there'll also be a view PDF option, which is the unofficial print. And those are all grayed out because I only have permissions to comment and verify. I'm going to go ahead and log off. And next, I'll log in as Rohin, who needs to approve this report. I'll again choose my asset server and database and search for my batches. Let me go over to 7225, check out reports. And its status is not yet approved. Let me go to report name. And I can see the verifications from Shrey, as well as his comments. And again, another comment here from Shrey. If I click on verifications, I can see which sections are verified and not, and what time. However, I'm not actually allowed to make comments or verifications myself. I'm also not allowed to unofficially or officially print this report, but I am allowed to approve it. It does call out the sections that have not been verified, and I'm going to approve it, and I need to type in my password for tracking. And now this report has been approved. It no longer requires further approvals, but it does need to be officially printed into a PDF. However, Rohin is not able to do that. I'm going to sign off and log in as my final user, Liam, to officially print this report. Let me log in as Liam. Choose my asset server and database. Search for the last 24 hours. I'll click on 7225 and go to reports. This report is now approved, but it still needs to be officially printed. Now, because I can officially print, I also have the ability to unofficially print. So to officially print, I'll click this print here. That will make a watermarked PDF. But I also do have the option of unofficially printing. Let me click on print, and it will create the PDF. It asks me to save it, and I'm going to hit cancel. It shows you the name of the PDF that was created. But also by default, there are two folders on your machine, on the C drive, the Adobe PDF location and Adobe PDF official. and here's my report. And I don't have Adobe on this machine, but I'm going to make a copy and paste it on another machine and show you. And here's my officially printed report. The approval is at the top, followed by a verification of that section, the information for that section, and then the comments at the bottom. The next section starts here. There's the official print watermark. And then the comments for that section are at the bottom here. You've now seen an example of printing in the RtReports generator, including comments and verifying, approving, and officially printing, as well as the security settings that are required to set this up. A final note on versioning. It's possible to create multiple versions of a report. Once version 2 of a report template has been released, all future batches will automatically be printed using that version of the report template. However, it's possible to change the effective dates to something other than the time of the release of the report. You could then end up in a situation where you may have already printed an event frame with version 1, but it's technically inside the effective times of version 2. But in this case, since you've already printed that event frame with version 1, you won't be able to with version 2.